वी आर लाइव।
नमस्ते, आई वेलकम एवरीवन टू द पंडित दीनदयाल उपाध्याय मेमोरियल एनुअल लेक्चर ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एज पार्ट ऑफ द 104th बर्थ एनिवर्सरी कमेमोरेशन ऑफ पंडित जी। एज वी ऑल नो, पंडित दीनदयाल उपाध्याय वॉज अ संघ प्रचारक हु लेटर बिकेम पार्ट ऑफ भारतीय जनसंघ एंड बिल्ट द पार्टी अलॉन्ग विद डॉक्टर श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी। His holistic vision of integral humanism, which charted own path for Bharat away from the bipolar world divided between various ideologies, contained India's ancient wisdom that has answers to many of our contemporary issues. Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh Bengaluru has been organizing Pandit Deendayal Upadhyaya Memorial Lecture every year since 1983. This is the 38th edition of this lecture series. Esteemed speakers who have delivered this lecture include renowned economist S. Gurumurthy, Sahasarkaryavaha of RSS, Shri Mukundaji, Dr. Krishna Gopalji, Shri Mukul Kanitkar, National Organizing Secretary of Bharatiya Shikshana Mandal, Shri B. L. Santoshji, National General Secretary of BJP, and many other dignitaries. This year, we are very fortunate to have Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi, member of Rajya Sabha and national spokesperson of Bharatiya Janata Party. We shall continue the program after Dharja Rohan and Dhwaja Pranam. I request Raghvendra Kulkarni, Bangalore Dakshin Vibhag Prachar Pramukh, to introduce today's speaker. Raghvendra Kulkarni ji. Raghavendra ji, Raghavendra ji. Thank you. हरि ओम राघवेंद्र जी
प्रशांत जी आई थिंक इज फेसिंग सम टेक्निकल इश्यू प्लीज प्रोसीड
टुडे वी आर फॉर्चुनेट टू हैव डॉक्टर सुधांशु त्रिवेदी मेंबर ऑफ राज्यसभा एंड नेशनल स्पोक्समैन भारतीय जनता पार्टी ड्यू टू टेक्निकल इश्यूज राघवन the person who had to introduce Dr. Sudhanshu Triveji is not joined in. So once he joined, we'll start the formal introduction. So in interest of time, I request Dr. Sudhanshu Triveji to start his lecture soon after the Ekal Geet.
नमस्कार भारत माँ के चरण कमल में तन मन धन कर दे न्योछावर साधक आज प्रतिज्ञा कर ले जननी के इस संकट पर जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर मन कर रहा आज हिमालय सिसक रही गंगा की धारा दगमग है कैलाश शंभु का व्यतीत आज बद्रीश्वर प्यारा उधर सुलगति वन्ही शिखालक बयकौपित निज नंदन वन है अमरनाथ के पावन मंदिर पर अरियों का क्रुद्ध नयन है निज माता की लाज बचाने हम सब आज बने प्रलयंकर साधक आज प्रतिज्ञा कर ले जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर मातृभूमि का कंकर कंकर आज महाशंकर बन जाए थिरक उठे तांडव की गति फिर विश्व पुनः कंपित हो जाए खुले तीसरा नेत्र तेज से अरिदल सारा भस्म सात हो चमके पुनः त्रिशूल करों में अरिशोणित से तप्त पात हो जय के नारे गूंजे नभ में दीप विजय का जले घर 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 साधक आज प्रतिज्ञा कर ले जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर डाणा के उस भीषण प्रण को आज पुनः हम सब दोहराए त्यज देंगे सारा सुख वैभव जब तक माँ का कष्ट न जाए क्या होगा माता के कारण अगर राष्ट्र के लिए मरें शयन घासों के छोटे खाकर भी सब व्यथा हरेंगे, निश्चित होगे विजय सत्य के, दुश्मन कांपेंगे थर थर थर, साधक आज प्रतिज्ञा कर ले, जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर, जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर, भारत माँ के चरण कमल में तन मन धन कर देनु छावर, साधक आज प्रति कर दे, जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर, जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर, जननी के इस संकट क्षण पर।
Now I request Shri Raghavendra Kulkarni, Bangalore Dakshin Vibhag Prachar Pramukh, to introduce today's speaker. Raghavendra ji.
Namaskara and good evening. I heartily welcome all the Swayamsevaks, well-wishers and the friends who are listening to this lecture program on the occasion of 104th birth anniversary of Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay ji. On behalf of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh Jayanagar Bengaluru, it's my great pleasure and an incredible honor to introduce today's speaker, Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji. Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji serves as Member of Parliament from Upper House Rajya Sabha, representing the Uttar Pradesh. Dr. Trivedi ji also serves as the national spokesperson of Bharatiya Janata Party. Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji did his PhD in mechanical engineering and served as a faculty in mechanical engineering department in couple of Indian universities, including the Mahatma Gandhi Chitrakoot Gramodaya Vishwavidyalaya. He also worked as information advisor to the former Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh and also as a political advisor to former BJP National President Shri Rajnath Singh ji. Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji is an ardent speaker on the issues of India's national policy, society, the ideological aspects of Bharatiya Janata Party. A voracious reader and an eloquent orator, Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji is known for his skills on debates and panel discussions. As one of the most popular panelists in several national TV debates, inki amrit vani mein bolna nahi hota hai, jab ye bolte hain to baraste hain, gyan sanskar aur adhyatmikata ka pavan vrushti hoti hai. We are fortunate to have Dr. Sudhanshu Trivedi ji for this year's Pandit Deendayal Upadhyaya Annual Memorial Lecture Program. I have been bestowed this great honor. Sir, I welcome you. Once again, I welcome each and everyone who is watching this live streaming on Facebook and YouTube for this annual lecture program. Dhanyawad. Over to sir.
परम पवित्र भगवा ध्वज, ऑल द प्रेजेंट संघ अधिकारी, ऑल स्वयं सेवक एंड ऑल दोज ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स हु आर वॉचिंग दिस ऑन वेरियस सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म, फेसबुक और यूट्यूब और अदर. एज वी नो दैट टुडे is the birth anniversary of Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay, who was not just only considered as an inspiration, motivation, and the fundamental motivation of our ideological thought of Bharatiya Janasangh and now Bharatiya Janata Party. But also, I can say, in post-independence India, one of the first and foremost original political thinker. This I'm saying with great responsibility. Because if you look, practically for long part of post-independent India, there were just three national parties, at least for the first 50 years. One was Congress, another was Communist, another was BJP or erstwhile Janasangh. Technically, since last 15, 20 years, Bahujan Samaj Party is also the national party. But if you look at the three main national parties, what happened? Congress was founded by a foreigner. Initially, it was founded as an instrument tool to be used by Britishers to handle the Indian aspirations so that they should not go beyond the limit. Communist Party was a part of an international movement. They never considered themselves as fundamentally Indian. That's why you will see that even in their name, it is not Indian Communist Party. It is Communist Party of India. Means they consider themselves as a branch of an international movement or like an India branch of a multinational. So both the parties were having thought ideas which were not inherently initiated from Indian origin. When Janasangh was formed in 50s, later when Deen Dayal ji has profounded this idea of integral humanism or Ekatma Manavad in 60s, at the time, two ideologies were prevailing all over the world. One was capitalism, another was communism. Both were having one difference between each other. Capitalism was saying that individual is first and foremost. The entire development should be focused on individual. And whenever the individuals get proper and ample opportunities to develop, the society will flourish. And in this individualism, do not care about others. Communism was saying that society should be dominating and individual identity is not that much important. It should be only and only society. So capitalism was saying that the resource should rest with individual, and communism was saying that the resources should rest with the society or practically with the government. This is just difference. Single difference between two, you can say this is nothing but an issue of the entitlement or ownership, that who will own the resources, a person or the government. But as far as the concept of utilizing the resources rather than exploiting the resources, both were same. The concept of how to deal with nature, both were same. The concept of how to have compassion in the society, by and large, same. So there was no much difference. Both were saying that the resources should be used, the nature should be exploited to the fullest capacity to serve the society, whether by individual source or by the government source. Both were having no compassion with nature. As far as society is concerned, you know very well that though communists have said that they care for the society, but as per some of the very established, authenticated researchers, to the extent of 10 crore people has been killed in the last 20th century by various government, mostly communist government, in the name of serving for the society. And as far as capitalism is concerned, they believe that individual has to flourish, not only totally ignoring others, but smashing others. So they have given the concept of cutthroat competition. So even at the cost of somebody else's life or existence, you are allowed to go ahead. Dindyalji thought that both these thoughts were neither Indian nor in the interest of the humanity. So everybody was saying individualism and materialism. Dindyalji has propounded this thought of humanism. So this was an idea that in India, you will say that what was the basic fundamental points of both communism and capitalism, which can be considered good and which can be considered bad. If you look, the biggest attraction or charm which communists provide, that we will ensure bread and butter to everybody, but we will not allow you to flourish. So the problem is, when you're not allowed to flourish, after a certain time, the inspirational instinct dilutes and the growth in the society stagnates and leads to subsequently decline in the society. Capitalism says, we will give you ample opportunity to flourish, but we do not guarantee bread and butter to everybody. Hamare yahan koi bhookha bhi hoga. Hamare yahan koi nirdhan beghar bhi hoga. There will be certain people who will be homeless and certain people who will not be having even a piece of bread to eat. But I will allow you to flourish to whatever extent you want. But if I ask you, what was the original Indian context? The Indian concept was totally different, which Dindyalji has found out. Both capitalism and communism say that if somebody is working with his full capacity, he should be allowed to get the benefit or dividend of that. This is the ideal state, whether it is capitalism or communism. Capitalism says, if he keeps on increasing his capacity, he should be allowed to keep on increasing the fruits. Communism says that he should be allowed to get the fruits of his activity, but beyond a certain limit, the government will take over. So, dono ka common siddhant kya tha? If I say a word in Hindi, jo aaya hai, so khayega. Jo kamayega, wo khilayega. Wo kahenge, jo kamayega, wo khayega. Means whosoever will earn, he will be having the right to eat. Par Bharatiya concept ye nahi tha. Bharatiya concept kya tha? Jo aaya hai, so khayega. Whosoever is born is having right to get bread and butter. Then who will ensure? Jo kamayega, wo khilayega. Whosoever will earn will ensure that whosoever is not having capacity or not earning should get the bread and butter. So there is a fundamental difference. Today we talk about democracy, political democracy. Political democracy says that everybody should have right to vote. Everybody should have an authority that he can have a say in the formation of the government. But Dindyalji has also talked about economic democracy. What is economic democracy? What is a social democracy? It is that everybody should have right to work and right to have a livelihood, right to have a bread and butter. Aaj khadya suraksha ki baat to aap karte hain. इसीलिए हमारे यहां कॉन्सेप्ट दिया गया, जो आया है सो खाएगा और जो कमाएगा वो खिलाएगा. देन यू विल से दिस इज दिस लुक्स लाइक एन यूटोपियन आइडिया. वेयर इज द प्रैक्टिकलिटी? इफ यू लुक एट द इंडियन सोसाइटी, द बेसिक फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी इज फैमिली. In family, what happens? In most of the Indian families, even today, one or at the most two members are earning, and they are feeding or taking care of rest of the members. आज स्थिति ये है कि अगर मैं नहीं कमाता हूँ, मेरा father कमाते हैं तो वो मेरा ध्यान रखेंगे. मेरा बड़ा भाई कमाता है वो मेरा ध्यान रखेगा. बेटा बेरोजगार है तो बाप मरते दम तक उसका ख्याल रखेगा. जो कमाएगा वो खिलाएगा. दिस इज एम्बेडेड इन द सोशल स्ट्रक्चर, सो इट मेक्स अस टोटली डिफरेंट देन बोथ द आइडियोलॉजीज विच वर प्रिवेलिंग एट द टाइम ऑफ 60s. एंड मोर ओवर वी हैव गॉन फर्दर बियॉन्ड दैट, नॉट जस्ट द मेंबर्स ऑफ अवर फैमिली. इफ यू लुक just 10 days back, the Shraddha Paksh or the Pitra Paksh have passed. In Pitra Paksh, on the day of or the tithi in which we decide to perform the Shraddha Karma for our ancestors, you know, when people used to, because people are not able to understand what was the sociology and what was the science behind these rituals. Whenever you called somebody or some purohit to have food, is he allowed to have the food first? No. First, you have to take three portions out, which one is for cow, one is for crow, one is for dog. What does this symbolize? Cow is considered to be a god among animals, a divine animal. Gomata. Dog is considered the vehicle of Bhairo. Bhairo ji is a god of Shamshan. And crow, Kauwa, is considered that element which normally eats dirty things. But we take care of all those. Why? Because if the God has made us the most developed creature of this nature, then it is incumbent on our part to symbolically take care of every living being in this world. So, crow symbolizes the one extreme, cow symbolizes another extreme, and dog symbolizes going towards the death. To jo kamayega, wo khilayega. That's why in Indian society you will see so many of instances ki kahin chitiyon ko dana dala ja raha hai, chitiyon ko shakkar yani sugar dali ja rahi hai, to kahin kabutron ko dana khilaya jata hai, to kahin chuhon ko doodh pilaya jata hai. And forget about that, even at the festival of Nag Panchami, even the cobras are being fed with milk. Jo kamayega wo khilayega. That's a vast thinking of Indian society. Then you can ask, okay, this might have been a very good idea. Or at the time of 60s, when capitalism and communism was prevailing, this could have been a matter of relevance. But now, in the 21st century, when the communism has almost shuddered and capitalism is shaking, what is the relevance of integral humanism today? In this context, I would like to ask, if I ask you, which are the two, three biggest problems which the world is facing today? Number one is ecological imbalances. No country in the world can say that they are not affected by the environmental issues or the ecological imbalances, the greenhouse effect or rising temperature or others. Second, most of the part of the world is affected by terrorism. There are certain countries which are not affected by terrorism, but most of the part are affected by terrorism. Third, the nuclear threat. Those countries who are having nuclear weapon or those who are not having nuclear weapon, all are having a nuclear threat. There is a doubt that any time they can be willingly or unwillingly destroyed. Right now we are having so much of nuclear weapons that entire earth population can be destroyed several times. Now if I ask you, what is the origin of this problem? Origin of this problem is non-integral attitude towards nature and the human being. Non-integral. Now I will use the word compartmental. The compartmental attitude between the various countries of the world, then the further self-centered compartmental attitude between the various societies in a country, that leads to terrorism. So first, we will look at the ecological imbalance, how it creates. Because the person or human considered ourselves different than nature. In the book written by Aristotle, in the Nature, the name of the book is Nature, he has written that all the elements of nature are for the service of the mankind. Then Francis Bacon writes that the entire world will be in wilderness if the man is not there. I think that René Descartes or someone says that man should become the possessor and masters of nature. Even in the book of Genesis, with due humility, I'm not commenting on any religious aspect, but this is fact that it is written that man should be able to subdue nature. Most of you people might be knowing or might not be knowing that what is the meaning of the word subdue? It is not an English word. It is originally a Hebrew word, which is having a strong military connotation. Subdue means to put down by like a javelin, a bhale ki nokh se dabane ko subdue kehte hain. So man should be able to subdue nature. This type of self-centered, compartmental attitude between man and nature has led to the modern day ecological imbalance, environmental destruction, and which has put question mark that if corrective measures are not taken, there can be a question mark on the existence of human race within a century, which had never happened in the documented history of mankind, that there is a question mark on the fundamental existence of mankind. Now, the same self-centered compartmental attitude further percolated within the human race among the various countries that I have to achieve at any cost, even at the cost of demolishing others, even at the cost of totally destroying others. That led to armed race and to the extent of weapons of mass destruction like atomic weapon and the nuclear weapon. That has led to the threshold of generic nuclear threat to the entire human race. Again, this is the second aspect which has put a question mark on the existence of entire human race, which has never happened before. Then the same self-centered compartmental attitude percolated down the line in the nation among the various sections of society that me, mine, my right, and it has to be at the cost of other. I don't care about other sections of society. It's only me and mine. And that feeling went to that extent, that self-centered compartmental attitude went to that extent that even at the cost of destroying and damaging other society, I have to take my right. That led to terrorism. At any cost, and if I'm unable to get, I will destroy you, I will damage you physically. But is the journey of that self-centered compartmental attitude stopped at the level of society? No. It has further percolated down the line. It has broken the joint families. Then the further broke percolated down the line, the self-centered compartmental attitude, and that has broken the families. Husband says, this is my right. Wife says, this is my right. Son and daughter says, this is my right. The brother and sister say, this is my right. So everybody is fighting about right, and the family gets dismantled. And the person remains alone. It's still, the self-centered and compartmental attitude's percolation has stopped. No, it has percolated down in our psyche, and the persons have become the victim of split personality, schizophrenia, psychic depression. आजकल तो बहुत depression की चर्चा सुनते हैं drugs के मामले में और दूसरे संदर्भों में. But मैं सिर्फ ये कहना चाहूंगा, that self-centered compartmental attitude has started breaking our relationship from mother nature to earth, to human race, to various countries and the societies, various societies in any nation, to the various families in the society, to the various members in a joint family, various families in joint family and various members in the family, and finally in ourselves. Sab kuch toot gaya. And we say that we are having a developed society. And which type of society? In which there is a survival of fittest, with a cutthroat competition. तो ये तो वो बात हो गई कि हम दूसरे को खत्म करके कहेंगे हम बचे रहेंगे, तो एक दूसरे के प्रति इस कतर नफरत. कुछ ऐसी बात हो गई कि एक ग्लास पानी में हम रेड चिली को घोलते रहेंगे, थोड़ी थोड़ी रेड चिली डालते रहेंगे, एंड वी विल इमेजिन वन डे इट विल बिकम अ स्वीट नेक्टर. नो, वन डे इट विल बिकम अ वेरी शार्प पॉइजन. तो दीज टाइप ऑफ थॉट्स, सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट, कट थ्रोट कंपटीशन, सो यू कैन से टुडेज वर्ल्ड इज स्टैंडिंग ऑन दिस सिचुएशन. एंड if you have seen, even the Western thinkers have given the thought, the clash of civilization. So clashy clash chal raha hai, civilization se leke, nature aur person se leke, within the family se leke, hamare andar ki consciousness ke split personalities tak. Now the answer lies where? When we shun the self-centered and compartmental attitude and go for integral attitude. Because fundamentally, the Indian thought process, which originated from the Vedic philosophy or the Upanishadic philosophy, which has been duly structured, crystallized by Dindyal Upadhyayji, that nothing is compartmental. Nothing is self. Everything is connected from one to another. Ab jaise maine example diya, hamare yahan se shuru karte the, ki ek vyakti hai. So in the Indian society, any member of the family never lives for himself or herself. जब आदमी व्यक्ति बच्चा होता है तो कोई भी बेटा या बेटी 90% अपने माँ बाप की इच्छाओं को पूरी करने के लिए जीते हैं. जब वो माँ बाप बन जाते हैं तो बच्चों की इच्छाएं पूरी करने के लिए जीते हैं. और आज भी ऐसे उदाहरण हैं कि भाई या बहनों को पढ़ाने के लिए लोगों ने अपनी जिंदगी सेक्रीफाइस कर दी. माँ बेटे के लिए और बूढ़ा बाप अपने यंग बेरोजगार बच्चे के लिए जिंदगी लगाता रहता है. यहां से एक कंसेंट्रिक इंटीग्रल अप्रोच. व्हेन इट कम्स एट द लेवल ऑफ सोसाइटी, तो हमारे क्या कहा गया है, नो वन इंडिविजुअल, ऑलवेज द सोसाइटी विल हैज टू बी टेकन केयर. जिसको आज आप कहते हैं मॉरल पुलिसिंग, नहीं, हमारे यहां समाज था. भले ही वो वर्ड्स आज लोगों को बहुत सही नहीं लगते हो, जात बिरादरी पंचायत, बट पंचायत वॉज अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग इंस्टीट्यूशन. देयर वॉज अ कलेक्टिव डिसीजन मेकिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ द सोसाइटी. यू हैव टू लिव इन द सोसाइटी एंड यू हैव टू फॉलो द गाइडलाइन, गाइडिंग लाइन प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द सोसाइटी. अब जब सोसाइटी से आगे आते हैं, देन कम्स द कंट्री. और जब कंट्री आता है तो कंट्री हमारे यहां एक जमीन का टुकड़ा नहीं है. It is a consciousness. ये एक सांस्कृतिक चेतना है. That's why we called our country Bharat Mata. जब वो इंटीग्रल एटीट्यूड ऊपर उठता है और कंट्री से आगे बढ़ के हम ग्लोबल लेवल पे आते हैं, देन वी बी कॉल्ड अयम निजा परो वेति गणना लघुचेत साम उदार चरितानां तु वसुधैव कुटुम्बकम्। मीन्स दिस इज माइन, दिस इज योर्स, दिस इज द थिंकिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ द मीन माइंडसेट पीपल, दोज हु आर हैविंग अ लार्ज हार्टेड एटीट्यूड। फॉर दिस द एंटायर वर्ल्ड इज अ फैमिली। और आज क्या कहते हैं, दुनिया एक बाजार है, द वर्ल्ड इज अ मार्केट एंड वी कंसीडर द वर्ल्ड इज अ फैमिली। इन मार्केट देयर इज अ कंपटीशन एंड इन फैमिली देयर इज अ कंपैशन। नाउ कम एट द लेवल ऑफ वर्ल्ड, और जब वर्ल्ड के लेवल पे आते हैं टुवर्ड्स नेचर, तो व्हाट वी से, माता भूमि पुत्रो हम पृथ्वीया, ये ऋग्वेद में लिखा है, भूमि मेरी माता है, मैं इसका पुत्र हूं। इन एन स्टार्किंग कंट्रास्ट टू व्हाट इज बीन रिटन इन द नेचर और व्हाट इज बीन रिटन इन द बुक ऑफ जेनेसिस, दैट वी हैव टू कंट्रोल द नेचर और द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ नेचर आर द सर्विस ऑफ अस। नो, दिस इज लाइक अवर मदर। अब कहते हैं हम प्रकृति माता है, तो यू आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गिव इन ब्रीफ वन एस्पेक्ट दैट वन सेक्शन टूडेज वर्ल्ड दैट वेस्टर्न थॉट keeps on breaking our relationship with a self-centered compartmental attitude from nature to world to nation to society to family to self. And the reverse is the integral humanistic approach that takes from inside to up towards the family and the society, the nation, to world, and then to nature. And not only this, wo ekatma manavvad iske aage bhi jata hai. If I ask you, who are you? In all the other cultures of the world, in all the other philosophical thoughts, religious thoughts of the world, everybody has said that they are in search of God, but their search is stopped somewhere outside, either in a place of worship or in any holy book, or with any messenger, but the God remains somewhere outside, detached from your self-identity. That is God, I am man. But this is again a self, it is a compartmental attitude. There is a compartmental difference between you and God. But the Indian concept says no compartmentalization. Hamare yahan kya kaha gaya hai? Who are you? Tum kaun ho? The answer is Aham Brahmasmi. I myself is a manifestation of divinity. So here the search of God has not stopped somewhere outside. It is inside. Not inside. Still, if it is inside, something different than me. But it is me. It is mine. I myself is the manifestation of divinity, Aham Brahmasmi. So here, the complete circle of integration completes, finally finishes. That's why there is a fundamental difference in the Indian concept of education and the Western concept of education. The difference is, in West, teacher wants to impart some knowledge in you. An Indian concept, Guru has need not to impart knowledge in you, because we consider that we ourselves is a divine instinct. But there is a certain element which has settled down in our mind, that is illusion of Maya. It has to be removed and the divinity will be realized. इसीलिए जो गुरु और शिष्य का जो श्लोक हमारे यहाँ बोला जाता है वो क्या है, ओम पूर्णमिदं पूर्णमदः पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। इट मीन्स आई एम इन्फिनिटी, ही इज इन्फिनिटी, आई हैव टू टेक आउट इन्फिनिटी आउट ऑफ हिम। पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते, आई हैव टेकन आउट इन्फिनिटी एंड द रेजिडुअल इज ऑल्सो इन्फिनिटी, बिकॉज वेन यू टेक आउट इन्फिनिटी आउट ऑफ इन्फिनिटी द रेजिडुअल हैज टू बी इन्फिनिटी। यहां पर आकर कंप्लीट इंटीग्रेशन हो जाता। और मैं अंत में ज्यादा समय न लेते हुए ये कहना चाहूंगा, ये तो था व्यक्ति से लेकर समाज तक का, और यदि राष्ट्र के बारे में कहें, Because of this thought, since we consider every human being as divine, we never wanted to convert anybody. Because divinity doesn't need to be manifested in one aspect or the other. In any aspect, it will remain divinity. It is has to be just, the things have to be removed. इसलिए हम किसी भी दुनिया के देश में गए, हमने उनको कभी खत्म करने की कोशिश नहीं की. That's why India is the only country in the world which never went for invasion, because Hinduism, if somebody considered it as a religion, we consider it as a way of life and culture. It has no concept of conversion. And from where it started, when Bhagwan Ram conquered Ayodhya, Lanka, has he annexed the kingdom of Lanka with Ayodhya? No. Has he appointed any deputy or viceroy there? No. Has he tried to convert Lanka as per their own beliefs? No. He has just appointed one of the members of their royal family, Vibhishan, and say, just you have to follow the certain principles and go ahead. That is the fundamental element of coexistence, and this is a reply to clash of civilizations. The so-called theory of the clash of civilization, that's why the Bhavya Ram Mandir, when it will come up, it will be like a symbol of coherence at the level of nation. How can two civilization coexist? How can nation coexist without dominating or trying to damage or control or convert others? Ram Mandir will be like a lighthouse. So Deen Dayal ji's concept of integral humanism is embedded in our entire tradition, from philosophy to polity to, again, I can say, if we come to the level of science, I just want to say one thing, because now the time is going ahead. I also want to have some question answers, whosoever is having anything in the mind. You can say, okay, these philosophies were good, but how I can say that the things will go ahead? One thing I would like to say, with the Prime Minister Modi, he has also included in his approach. You know, there is a word unemployment in the English world. The Hindi word for unemployment is called berozgari. This is not a Hindi word. This is a Persian word. In any of the Indian language and Sanskrit, there is no synonym for the word unemployment. There's no translation for the word unemployment or berozgari. Why? There was no concept of berozgari. Everybody was born with some employment in the hand, and the employment was not superior or inferior, because we were the dazzling prosperity at the time of the world. It was in the dark ages. Just one example I would like to give, that, you know, today America's contribution to the global GDP is around 14 to 15%. As per the East India Company's document, at the time of Aurangzeb, our contribution was 22%, and at the time of Shah Jahan, it was 29%. So obviously, at the time of Gupta Empire, Magadha Empire, Chola Empire, or Vijayanagar Empire, or Vedic age, it has to be 42%. Means three times more prosperity than United States. कोई ऊंचा कोई नीचा कोई बड़ा वो नहीं था. There are certain historical documents available, but I'm not going in the detail. Just I want to say, सबके पास रोजगार था. ये तो beyond thinking थी कि nobody is having nothing to do. इसीलिए धर्म का कोई पर्यायवाची वहां पर नहीं है, और बेरोजगारी का कोई पर्यायवाची हमारे यहां नहीं है. So there was a robust economic system, there was a robust cultural system, there was a robust family system, and the family system was so strong. अभी मैंने भगवान राम का जिक्र किया. विभीषण तो भगवान राम का भक्त था. किसी के बेटे का नाम विभीषण होता है? नहीं. भगवान राम से लड़ने वाला रावण का पुत्र मेघनाथ, मेघनाथ नाम होता है, इंद्रजीत भी नाम होता है. उसके दो नाम थे, इंद्रजीत और मेघनाथ. इंद्रजीत नाम भी होता है, मेघनाथ नाम भी होता है. इसलिए कहने का तात्पर्य यह है कि फैमिली इतनी स्ट्रॉन्ग वैल्यूज थी कि अगर आपने भगवान का भी साथ दिया है परंतु फैमिली की वैल्यूज को उसके ऊपर रखा गया, सच स्ट्रॉन्ग इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच इन अवर सोसाइटी वॉज देयर, इसे समझने की जरूरत है। दैट्स वाई आई कैन से, मैं फर्स्ट टाइम जब यूएस गया था आज से 20 years बिफोर, तो वहां बड़ा, उस जमाने में भारत में मॉल्स नहीं थे, इस ढंग के बड़े बड़े एक्सप्रेस वे नहीं थे, हमारे एयरपोर्ट्स ऐसे नहीं थे। तो हमारे जो फ्रेंड्स गए थे उन्होंने कहा भारत में ऐसा कब होगा, मैंने कहा नो प्रॉब्लम, जस्ट इन 20 years एवरीथिंग कैन बी इन इंडिया, वी नीड जस्ट अ गुड गवर्नमेंट एंड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी, बट जो हमारे यहाँ है वो वहां पर 20 generations में भी नहीं होगा, दैट इज द फैमिली वैल्यू। सो इंटीग्रल ह्यूमनिज्म को अगर समझना है तो वो एक ऐसी चीज है जो इकोनॉमी से लेके, एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन से लेके, कंट्री से लेके आपकी कॉन्शियसनेस तक हर चीज को जोड़ के एक सूत्र में पिरो देती है। और इसीलिए वी आर द ओनली कंट्री, आजकल चाइना के साथ बड़ा कॉन्फ्लिक्ट चल रहा है और एक बहुत बड़े चाइनीज थिंकर हुए हुशी, जिन्होंने ये वर्ड बोला था कि इंडिया हैज कल्चरली डोमिनेटेड एंड कंट्रोल्ड चाइना फॉर मोर देन 2000 years विदाउट सेंडिंग अ सिंगल सोल्जर अक्रॉस द बॉर्डर। तो इसलिए मैं ये कहते हुए कि हमारी जो दर्शन है, जो हमारा वैचारिक दर्शन है, वो सारे विश्व के लिए 21st century में एक नया स्वरूप बनाएगा, एक नया रास्ता दिखाएगा। और अटल जी की कविता की एक पंक्ति है, और वो रास्ता कहां से निकलेगा, हमारे ही विचारों से निकलेगा, उसी हिंदू संस्कृति से निकलेगा जिसको कि बार बार सांप्रदायिक कहकर लांछित करने का प्रयास किया जाता है। तो उनकी बहुत एक प्रसिद्ध कविता थी, हिंदू तनमन हिंदू जीवन, रग रग हिंदू मेरा परिचय। तो उसी की मैं यह पंक्ति कहना चाहूंगा कि आज के समय में हम दुनिया के सामने क्या आदर्श दिखा सकते हैं जो सिर्फ हमारे पास है, कि होकर स्वतंत्र मैंने कब चाहा, मैं कर लूं जग को गुलाम, मैंने तो सदा सिखाया है करना अपने मन को गुलाम। गोपाल राम के नामों पर कब मैंने अत्याचार किया, कब दुनिया को हिंदू करने घर घर में नरसंहार किया, कोई बतलाए काबुल में जाकर कितनी मस्जिद तोड़ी, भूभाग नहीं शत शत मानव के हृदय जीतने का निश्चय, हिंदू तनमन हिंदू जीवन, रग रग हिंदू मेरा परिचय। तो हम खुद के ऊपर कंट्रोल करने आए हैं, हम दुनिया पे कंट्रोल करने के लिए नहीं आए हैं, इसीलिए हम ही दुनिया को एक रास्ता दे सकते हैं। और हमारे पास क्या है, वो रास्ता हम सिर्फ मेटीरियल नहीं, स्पिरिचुअल भी दे सकते हैं। इसी कविता की आगे लाइन है, मैं अखिल विश्व का गुरु महान, बस ये लाइन कहकर बात खत्म करता हूं। वी डजंट वांट टू बिकम द सुपर पावर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, बिकॉज द सुपर पावर इज हैविंग द कैपेबिलिटी टू डोमिनेट, वी वॉन्ट टू हैव द कैपेबिलिटी टू मोटिवेट। सो वी वॉन्ट टू बिकम जगत गुरु, जगत गुरु मोटिवेट्स एंड द सुपर पावर डोमिनेट्स। तो इसी कविता की एक पंक्ति है, मैं अखिल विश्व का गुरु महान, देता विद्या का अमर दान, मैंने दिखलाया मुक्ति मार्ग, मैंने सिखलाया ब्रह्म ज्ञान, मेरे वेदों का ज्ञान अमर, मेरे वेदों की ज्योति प्रखर, मानव के मन का अंधकार क्या कभी सामने सका ठहर, मेरे स्वर नभ में गहर गहर, सागर के जल में छहर छहर, इस कोने से उस कोने तक कर सकते जगती सौरभमय, हिंदू तनमन हिंदू जीवन, रग रग हिंदू मेरा परिचय। धन्यवाद।
धन्यवाद सुधांशु जी। वी हैव रिसीव्ड सेवरल क्वेश्चंस, सो आई विल रीड आउट टू देम, रीड आउट टू यू, एंड इंटरेस्ट ऑफ टाइम वी विल हैव टू लिमिट बिकॉज़ वी हैव रिसीव्ड लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस। द फर्स्ट वन इज, वी आर इंक्रीजिंगली कॉट इन द रेस फॉर जीडीपी, एस्पेशली आफ्टर the lockdown and downturn in economy. But as we move towards Atmanirbhar Bharat, how do we solve the dichotomy between globalization, GDP on one side and becoming Atmanirbhar using Pandit Ji's views on economy?
What happens, this entire concept of GDP is having very peculiar aspect. I can just give you two examples. If in a country, 100 acres of forest trees have been cut and they are exported, the GDP has increased. But what about the damage of the environment? The other aspect, the increase in the jobs. One husband wife was living together and only husband was having a job and they were living happily. Suddenly the tussle started between them and both left apart. Now wife has also started seeking for job and finally she got the job. So two jobs are created. Now both needs one servant or maid servant at their home. So they have employed one maid servant. So three new jobs have been created. Is the happiness increased? So as far as the globalization, GDP and other things, sirf ek example dunga. Cultural aspect of economy ke upar ek bahut bade thinker hue hain, Max Weber. Max Weber has propounded a theory 100 years back that the Catholic societies are less development capacity and the Protestants are more, because Protestants allow the individuals to flourish. And he has given a thesis in 1920s that the two societies in the world, that is India and China, will always remain burden on earth because they are Hindu and Buddhist. They believe in the karma, they believe in rebirth, and they live in the other world. अब आज आप तुमसे पूछिए कि क्या स्थिति है, इंडिया और चाइना कहाँ है और वो कहाँ है? तो इसलिए जो जीडीपी का कॉन्सेप्ट है, जो एम्प्लॉयमेंट का कॉन्सेप्ट है, जैसे मैंने आपसे कहा ना कि ये जो स्टार्टअप्स है, ये स्वरोजगार, इसीलिए हमारे यहाँ बेरोजगारी ऐसी चीज नहीं थी. एंड प्राइम मिनिस्टर अंडरस्टूड एंड स्टार्टेड इनिशिएटिंग इन दिस. बस एक बात फंडामेंटली समझ लीजिए, इन एवरी कॉन्सेप्ट वी आर हैविंग एन ऑल्टरनेटिव आइडिया and much more experienced and accurate idea than the West. And if 21st century is going to be the century of India, it not only just on the economic front, but in the totalitarian front. हम चाइना की तरह नहीं है कि वहां का भी जो प्राइम मिनिस्टर है वो भी सूट कोट टाई पहनने लगे और वो पूरी तरीके से, वहां का यूथ सिर्फ डिस्कोथेक और पब में दारू पी के झूमने लगा और वहां की भी ओल्ड एज महिलाएं भी वेस्टर्न अटायर्स पहन के घूमने लगी और सिर्फ ईट ड्रिंक एंड बी मैरी रह गया. तो यू हैव बिकम द कल्चरल कॉलोनी ऑफ द वेस्ट. हमारे पास सबका जवाब है. तो अर्थ जो व्यवस्था दीनदयाल जी ने बताई है, वह अर्थव्यवस्था एक ऑल्टरनेटिव अर्थव्यवस्था है और वो उस पर काफी लंबा समय लगेगा. बस मैं सिर्फ ये कहना चाहता हूं, व्हेन इंडिया विल इमर्ज, इट विल इमर्ज विद अ ग्रैंड ऑल्टरनेटिव मॉडल विच इज हैविंग कैपेसिटी to answer all the questions, whether it is economic, social, political, or cultural.
Dhanyavad Sudhanshu ji. Next question. Modern day capitalism is seeping into our society. Every company, organization wants to increase profits. In this case, how does one apply integral humanism here?
ये भी आपने अच्छा क्वेश्चन किया. आफ्टर द फॉल ऑफ यूएसएसआर इन 1991, देयर वाज अ वेरी फेमस राइटर फ्रांसिस फुकुयामा इन अमेरिका, हु हैज रिटन द एंड ऑफ द हिस्ट्री एंड द लास्ट मैन. ही हैज सेड नाउ द फाइनली द वेस्ट हैज प्रूवन दैट देयर मॉडल ऑफ कैपिटलिज्म एंड द फ्री मार्केट इकोनॉमी इज द ओनली वे फॉर ग्रोथ. एंड ही हैज यूज्ड अ फेमस वर्ड, इट इज बेस्ट फॉर द रेस्ट टू फॉलो द वेस्ट. Propounded this theory in 1991, just after 25 years. The proponent of this theory, America, in 2016, as soon as Donald Trump came to power, what he said? He has withdrew from the Pacific Agreement. And what he has started saying, forget about the rest. Think of America first. So, bhai, 25 saal mein toh aapki theory kinare ho gayi. Toh ye jo aapne capitalism, free market oriented theory di hai, it has even not lived for 25 years, despite having no resistance from anywhere in the world, because it is having inherent problem. So, आज के जमाने में अगर आप केवल केवल materialism की बात करते हैं, मैं सिर्फ ये line कहूंगा, एक अंतर क्या है कि हमारे यहाँ हर चीज में divine conscious element देखा जाता है और उनके यहाँ हर चीज में material monetary aspect देखा जाता है. You might have heard this word, कि अमेरिका में मार्केटिंग स्ट्रेटजी जो पढ़ाई जाती है, फिलिप कॉटलर वगैरह बहुत बड़े मार्केटिंग के गुरु हैं, तो वो क्या पढ़ाते हैं, द चर्चेज आर लाइक द शॉप्स वेयर यू गिव मनी एंड बाय सेटिस्फैक्शन. और हमारे यहाँ क्या कहा गया है, पैसा भी लक्ष्मी माता है, पैसा भगवान है. तो हमारे यहाँ एवरीथिंग इज कॉन्शियस वेदर इट इज अ मनी. सो ऑब्वियसली द फाइनेंशियल इकोनॉमी एंड अदर थिंग्स इज हैविंग अ टोटल डिफरेंट. और वन मोर थिंग, उनकी इकोनॉमी का कॉन्सेप्ट क्या है अलॉन्ग विद सोसाइटी, दे से देयर कैन नेवर बी फ्री लंच एंड इफ देयर इज फ्री लंच इट हैज टू हैव पॉइजन. हमारे यहां के देखिए, दक्षिण भारत के बड़े बड़े मंदिरों से लेके अमृतसर के गुरुद्वारे तक ये फ्री का लंगर चलता है. व्हाट इज दिस, इसमें पॉइजन है क्या? द पॉइजन इज योर माइंड, योर माइंड सेट. आप हर 50 साल में अपनी थ्योरी बदलते हैं, 100 साल बाद उसको बकवास कर लेते हैं. हमारे यहाँ थ्योरी है द CSR, द कॉर्पोरेट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. आपने अब सोचा है, इफ यू लुक एट द 50-60 ईयर्स बैक, हमारे यहाँ बड़ा सेठ वो नहीं माना जाता था जिसका कैपिटल बड़ा, जिसका टर्नओवर बड़ा, जिसके एसेट्स बड़े. नो, जिसने ज्यादा मंदिर बनवाए, जिसने ज्यादा पाठ स्कूल बनवाए, जिसने पाठशाला बनवाए, जिसने तालाब खुदवाए. सो अवर इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सेप्ट वॉज हैविंग एन इंटीग्रेटेड ह्यूमनिस्टिक अप्रोच. And they were having a self-centered compartmental attitude that is also full of deceit. Why I'm saying the full of deceit? Marketing ka sabse bada example kya mana jata hai ki ganje aadmi ko kanga bhej de. If you are able to sell a comb to a bald man, you are the best salesman. But selling comb to a bald man is not a cheating. That's why it is full of deceit. It is full of cutthroat competition. So, finally, we are having a totally different model and world will have to follow us. Aap chinta mat kariye, communism ka downfall 90s mein dekha. Maine Francis Fukuyama ki theory ka aapka 2016 mein bataya. Wait for a few more years. The time is arriving.
Dhanyawad ji. This will be the last question in the interest of time. There are very few academic works on concept of integral humanism and on Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay ji's life and legacy. So what are the efforts being made to make it more easily accessible in academic texts and also ensure that it reaches our younger generation, the next generation especially?
You have raised a very valid question. The problem has become because Deen Dayal ji was a president of Janasangh. So those who are against us politically, they have branded this concept as a political concept. So they have tried their tooth and nail that these thoughts should not come across to the society, that they were the first and foremost individual indigenous thought, which has came to the Indian political scenario. After our government came, and even previously, Deen Dayal Shodh Sansthan, Rashtra Dharma and the Lokhit publication and others have published the structured volume of Deen Dayal ji. In 2016, if you remember in the Calicut session, the books have been properly inaugurated by the Prime Minister. So now ample amount of literature is available as far as it has to be included in the teaching and other things. It will have to be taken care of with a particular aspect, because you know that whenever we try to correct the wrongdoings of the facts in education or history, we have been blamed on doing the saffronization of the education and other. But definitely these elements, and one more thing, Deen Dayal ji has not given anything totally new. He has just formulated, defined, articulated our eternal thoughts. The eternal ethos of Indian consciousness has been articulated in the modern contemporary context. So we can understand through Deen Dayal ji's integral humanism with ample number of options which are available right now.
Dhanyawad, Sridhanshu ji. Now, before we end, we will have sung Prarthana. But before that, it is my duty to deliver the vote of thanks. I thank Dr. Sudhanshu Triveji ji for delivering the annual Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay Memorial Lecture today. You have rightly highlighted the faults in the compartmentalized approach towards society at the cost of others versus Pandit ji's Ekatma Manavvad, which guides us towards happiness of all. Your address has also laid down the tasks ahead of us, inspired by the path shown by Pandit Deendayal ji. I thank you again, ji. I also thank everyone who worked for this event and made this program possible. I also thank everyone of you who have joined for this lecture. Prarthana. Now.
Sava Uttishtha Prarthana. Namaste Sadaste Matrume.
Namaste Sadaste Matrume.
महामंगले पुण्य भूमे त्वदर्थे
महामंगले पुण्य भूमे त्वदर्थे
पतत्वेशकायो नमस्ते नमस्ते
पतत्वेशकायो नमस्ते नमस्ते
इमं हिंदू राष्ट्रांग भूता
प्रभो शक्तिमन हिंदू राष्ट्रांग भूता
इमे सादरन्त्वामो वयम्
इमे सादरन्त्वामो वयम्
त्वदीयाय कार्याय बद्धा कटियम्
त्वदीयाय कार्याय बद्धा कटियम्
सुभाशिषं देहि तत्
शुभामाचि चन्देतपूर्तये
अजय्यां च विश्वस्य देहीश शक्तिम्
अजय्यां च विश्वस्य देहीश शक्तिम्
सुशीलं जगत्येन नम्रं भवे
सुशीलं जगत्येन नम्रं भवे
श्रुतं चैव यत्कण्टकाकीर्णमार्गम्
श्रुतं चैव यत्कण्टकाकीर्णमार्गम्
स्वयं स्वीकृतं नः सुगन्धाये
स्वयं स्वीकृतं नः सुगन्धाये
समुत्कर्ष निःश्रेयसस्यैकमुग्रम्
समुत्कर्ष निःश्रेयसस्यैकमुग्रम्
परं साधनं नाम वीरव्रतम्
परं साधनं नाम वीरव्रतम्
विजेत्री च न संहता कार्यशक्ते
विजेत्री च न संहता कार्यशक्ते
विधायास्य धर्मस्य संरक्षणम्
विधायास्य धर्मस्य संरक्षणम्
परो वै भवन् नेतुमेतत् स्वराष्ट्रम्
परं वै भवन् नेतुमेतत् स्वराष्ट्रम्
समर्था भवत्वा शिशाते भृशम्
समर्था भवत्वा शिशाते भृशम्
भारत माता की जय
भारत माता की जय भुजं प्रणाम एक दो तीन संगा वी किरा